If I want to get safely from point A to point B, I need precision, dexterity, and control. See? Let's talk about the brain behind the brawn of the space launch system.
That's one small step for man.
Traveling through space is hard. That's why NASA's space launch system will have to be the most powerful rocket in the world. How is SLS able to meet the challenges of exploring deep space? Well, there are no small steps.
So what made the difference with our skateboard? It was built for speed and it had weight to pull it in the direction that we wanted it to go. But it was missing a brain and a complex nervous system to guide it. The space launch system may be the biggest rocket in the world, but its successful journey depends on combining its power with well-reasoned decisions and actions. The thing that turns a big, powerful machine like SLS into a smart, precise vehicle capable of interplanetary travel is avionics. Behind me are the core stage avionics. Avionics, which literally means aviation plus electronics, is the computers, the routers, the power systems, the processors, and the software that tell SLS what to do. Avionics is a lot like our body's nervous system, and that begins with the brain. This is the mind of SLS. It's three identical flight computers, which make split-second decisions about trajectory and navigation. Now, the cool thing about these powerful computers is that when they receive information, they each process it independently and decide on an action. They compare the results, and in the unlikely event that one of them decides differently than the other two, it's outvoted. The SLS avionics are so important that the entire system has already been running simulated missions in Artemis, a virtual launch environment. SLS will have imagined its journey hundreds of times, so every decision it makes will be the right one. To get information to make decisions, the flight computers rely on sensors all around the rocket, in the same way that our brain gets sensory information from our eyes, our ears, our fingers, and so on. The SLS's avionics controller boxes and over 55 miles of cabling act as its nerve and nerve endings, carrying information to and from the flight computers. As you can see, getting where we want to go requires so much more than strength and speed. It also requires an intelligent, complex system to get us to deep space. To pull off a trick like that, I'm gonna have to use my brain. But right now my brain is telling me that we're out of time. Thanks for watching.